Good morning, students. In today's class, I am going to teach a new poem to you from your English literature book. The poem name is From the Nightingale and the Globe. From the Nightingale and the Globe poem was written by William Cowper. William Cowper is a very famous English poet. His poetry is a little different from the other's poetry because in his poetry, we observe the main scene is the English countryside. English village side, whatever the beautiful sceneries are there, whatever the beautiful places are there, that places, that sceneries he will take as the main setting in his poetry. That is the reason his poetry is a little different from the others. Here also, in this poem, From the Nightingale and the Globe, the main setting if you observe, it is the English countryside, it is the hawthorn. Hawthorn tree is a shrub, an indigenous plant that we will observe in the English countryside. It is having the white and red color flowers and also small dark berry like fruits. Here, if you observe the main theme of this, the Nightingale and the Globe poem. The central idea of this poem is universal brotherhood. In our world, there are so many castes are there are so many religions are there are so many individual differences are there among the people based on their caste, based on their religion, based on their color, based on their nativity. Though we are having these all the differences, we all people are the one. We all people are the brothers and the sister. The concept is called as the universal brotherhood. That is the central idea of this poem. It's what is the main theme of this poem is peace and harmony. Suppose the people maintain this universal brotherhood, they believe the concept universal brotherhood, definitely they can live in peace and harmony. That is the main theme of this poem. Now if we observe the poetic devices that I can use in this poem, the main poetic device is the personification. Personification means giving the human attributes to the non-living things is called as the personification. In this poem, the Nightingale and the Globe, they were unable to talk like the humans. They were unable to make a conversation between them like the people. But here the Nightingale and the Globe, they were making a conversation between them like the humans. Here also, the Nightingale is addressed as the he. That is the reason we can say the writer applied the personification poetic device in this poem by giving the human attributes to the things, animals like Nightingale and Globe. Next, we have the one more poetic device, that is the rhyming scheme. When I am explaining this poem to you, I will explain you this rhyming scheme also too. Now, we will move to the poem. A Nightingale that all day long have cheered the village with his song. Not yet at eve, his note suspended. Here if you observe, the total day, continuously the Nightingale is singing the beautiful, melodious, sweet song to cheer the people, to admire the people with its beautiful and melodious song. Though it is the evening, it didn't stop singing, still it was singing that song and it was admiring the people with its beautiful and melodious song. Not yet, when eventide was ended, began to feel as well he might the keen demands of time. After the evening, it stopped its singing because it developed that hunger. It was feeling very hungry. It developed that appetite. To suppress that hunger, it stopped that singing. And it was spied, means it was looking at the surroundings. Is there any food which is available to that globe? To the Nightingale. To suppress its hum. When looking eagerly around, he spied off, far off, upon the ground. There's something shining in the dark, and knew the globe by his spot. So stooping down from path on top, he thought to put him his crown. Then by evening, as it was feeling very hungry, it was looked at the surroundings. Then finally, a glowing worm, it was observed on the ground. That is a globe. It is having the shining body already in view. Then it came down from the top of the tree to have the bird as its prey. It want to throw the globe into its crop as its prey. With that intention, it got down from the top of the tree. That is the hawthorn that I already mentioned in the set. The worm, aware of his intent, harangued him thus right eloquent. Did you admire my lamb? quoth he, as much as your minstrels, you would abhor to do me wrong, as much as I to spoil your song. Here the glover understand the intention of the nightingale. I think the nightingale is going to eat me as its prey. I think it was going to swallow me into its throat. With my wit, with my intelligence, with my ideas, I have to escape from this. Then it made one idea, that is the flatter. I want to flatter the nightingale with my words, my admiring words. After making that nightingale to be flattered with my words, I have to escape from that nightingale. Then immediately it said, have you like my glowing body? Like that, my dear friend nightingale, I like your song. Have you like my glowing body? That same way, I like your beautiful, melodious and sweet song. Like this, the glover said. Next is saying, I think you are going to spoil my body, that shining body that you like. I think I am going to spoil your sweet song. Actually here the glover is saying the exaggeration. Because the glover is not having any capacity to spoil the song of the nightingale. But it is saying that how I am going to spoil your beautiful sweet song. In such a way, I think you are having a thought in your mind that you are going to spoil my shiny body. But was the self-same power divine taught you to sing and me to shake. In these lines, if you observe, it is saying about the divine power, what the two animals are having, the nightingale and the glover. The nightingale is able to make the people to be admired with its beautiful, sweet and melodious song. Even the glover also can make the dark night as the very bright night with its shading. The two divine powers, the two animals, the nightingale and the glover are happy. That you with music, I with light, might beautify and cheer the night. That same, what's the explanation I gave to you, that the glover is same. That I will make the dark night to be very bright and you will cheer the people with your beautiful song. The songster heard his soft oration and warbling out his approbation, releasing him as my story tells, and found a supper somewhere else. Then this nightingale is convinced with the whatever the narration that is made by the glover about their natural divine powers, that is the singing and making the total night to be very bright. The divine powers, that concept, this nightingale was convinced. Then it don't want to take the glover as its prey. It flew away from that place to search for the another. In this explanation, if you observe, this nightingale's personality is the complex and contradictory. In the first few lines, the nightingale is admiring the people, cheering the people with its beautiful song. But in the next lines, if you observe, it acts as a predator, thought to kill one animal as its prey, the glover as its prey. In the first one, first few lines, it is cheering the people. Second one, it thought to kill the another animal as its prey. So that is the reason you can see the nightingale personality is the very complex and contradictory. Next here, one more explanation is the divine power. The nightingale is having the divine power that is singing. It's make the other people to feel very cheered, to be admired with its beautiful and melodious song. Next, the shining divine power it is there to the glover. This glover is able to make a dark night as the very bright night with its shining body. Next here, the one more explanation I already told you, that the glover thought to flatter the nightingale to escape from it. Otherwise, this nightingale eat the glover as its prey. That is the reason it flattered the nightingale. How it was flattering the nightingale, that we are having the two divine powers, that you are able to sing very beautifully and make the people to be admired. And I am able to make dark night as the very bright night. We are people should live in this world with peace and harmony, like brothers and sisters. We have to maintain that universal brotherhood. But we should not kill each other. Suppose if we maintain the universal brotherhood, we can live in God, we can live in this world with peace and harmony. Such a way it is convincing that nightingale that it should not eat the globe. Next, here also one more concept I told you, that how you are going to destroy my body, I am going to spoil your soul. It's kind of exaggeration only, because the globe is not having the capacity to spoil the nightingale's soul, but the nightingale is able to spoil its shining body just to protect itself from the nightingale, just to escape from the nightingale. It is saying, I am able to spoil your soul. That way you are also able to destroy my body. You are able to spoil my shining. Just to escape from the animal, you are saying this one. Next, here the rhyme scheme, if you observe. In this poem, in each two lines, kind of a set of rhyming words, different set of rhyming words were used by the writer. The first two lines, if you observe, long and song. It is one set. Yeah. Next two lines, it is suspended, ended. At the end, these rhyming words are there, suspended and ended. These two words are not rhyming with the long and song. That's why suspended and ended, you have to set as the BB set. Next, fifth and sixth lines, if you observe, mind upon. This is also, this set also, it is different from the first set and second set. This mind and appetite is not rhyming with the long or song. They are not rhyming with the suspended and ended. That's what we can say. These two rhyming words are also a different set of rhyming words. That's what it is the deed. Like this, if you observe, round, ground, it is the ee. Next, for, top, crop, top, crop, intent, eloquent. Like this, there are so many. Different sets of the rhyming words we will observe in this poem. Okay, but if you observe the 17th and 18th line, here the wrong and song it is there. But these two wrong and song rhyming words are rhyming with the long and song. That is the first two rhyming words. That's what we can say here. This rhyming scheme also the A. Next, 21, 22. If you observe, that is the light and night. These two words also rhyming with the mind and uptight. That is there in the third set of rhyming words. That's for this 21 and 22 lines also, whatever the rhyming words are there. This two rhyming words, light and night. These two rhyming words we can give the same set. That is the CC, because these are rhyming with the mind and uptight, that we use in the third set of the rhyming words in this book. Okay, like this, if you take the rhyming scheme, it is AA, BB, CC, DD, EE, FF, GG, HH, AA, II, CC, JJ, K. Okay, finally, I want to say that the writer is using the different sets of the rhyming words throughout his poem. To each two lines, one set of rhyming word he used. That is the rhyming scheme we can observe in this poem. Okay, my dear student, along with this poem, I am giving this lesson question and answers also to you. You please observe this teaching video and also the animation regarding this from the nightingale and the globe poem. After understanding this concept very properly, you please write the given question and answers in your class work along with the textual notes.